In this video, I want to show you guys my top three most commonly used animations that I like to use in PowerPoint. So without further ado, let's get started. Right now, if I go into presentation mode, you're just going to see, okay, blank title slide, title, line, subtext, great. Well, what I want to do is I want to make this a nice clean animation. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on this text right here, then go to animations, and I'm going to add a fade animation. And I'm also going to add a line animation. All right, so I'm going to open up this animation pane right here. I'm going to make both of these with previous, and then I'm going to decrease this just a bit. And then I'm also going to move this over with a slight delay of 0.25 seconds. Now, the reason why I like to have this fade part come in a little after the line's already moving, so that way the text comes in nice and smoothly without being kind of choppy where it appears and then it starts to move. I just want it to slowly appear and be moving at the same time. So that's why I like to put a little delay on the fade animation for this text. So as you can see right here, it's actually going to start right here and then end right here. Well, I actually want to do the complete opposite. So I'm going to go up here into effect options and do up. And now it's going to go upwards, but now it's going too far up. So if I click on this, I can actually manipulate where these are going to start. So I'm going to have this text start kind of right where this line is. And then I'm just holding down shift while I'm doing this. I'm going to click on this red dot and I'm just going to drag this all the way down to where my text is. So now this is just going to come up very so slightly and it's going to appear nice and smooth. So let's play this real quick just to see. All right, so that looks kind of nice. So let's actually decrease this because we don't need it to be 2 seconds. That's just too long. All right, that looks kind of nice. And I'm going to go in here into effect options and say smooth end. All right, so now we have the first part. So what we can then do is I'm going to actually use this text, click on animation painter tool because I don't want to have to duplicate efforts here. And I'm going to click on the subtext and now it's going to come in from the bottom to the top, but we actually want to do the opposite. So this isn't a problem. All I have to do is basically take this green dot and move it up here. And then also if you did want to, you could just change it to be down. But in this case, I'm just going to do it manually. So I'm just going to kind of line it up with this white line. And then it's going to end right where my text is. All right, so I'm going to click off that. So now if I go into presentation mode, it comes in nice and smoothly, the top and the bottom. Now we could end here, but what I really like to do is actually add an animation to this line. So I'm going to do a split animation and I'm going to go here to effect options and do vertical out. And then I'm going to do with previous and let's see how this now looks in presentation mode. Ah, that looks nice and smooth, and it really didn't take us that long to make. I also have a link to this template in the description below, so make sure to check out that. But this is just a nice title transition that you can use for any of your slides. All right, so the next one I really like to use is where I'm going to actually have this text right here, all this, come in from the right to the left. All right, so basically, all I have to do in order to make this happen is I'm going to select this and I'm going to do a fly in and then I'm going to choose from right and then I'm going to say with previous and then increase this a bit, the duration to 1 second. Go here to effect options, increase the smooth end to be 1 second. Hit OK. And look at that. Look how smoothly that comes in. Oh, it's
nice.
You could even do this for the man as well on the left. So if I wanted to do that, I could click on this one, animation painter tool, click on this, and then I could just say from the left. And now let's go into presentation mode and see how this looks. Ooh, I like how that looks. All right, so the last animation I want to show you guys is a little outside of the animation pane, but it's still a type of animation. So I'm going to show you guys exactly what I mean by this. As you see here in slide 3, if I go into presentation mode, you're just going to see the man, hiking stats, Q1. Now, why I'm saying Q1, no idea. We're just going to pretend this hiker's in quarter 1 for whatever it may be. I don't know. But you'll get the idea in just a bit. So basically, we have Q1 here, and then we have Q2 right here. So if I go into presentation mode, and then I just hit the right arrow, look at this. My bars go from left to right, they grow, and then it changes to Q2. So I'm going to show you guys how I did this. So if you created your first slide like this, just right click, duplicate it, change, you know, whatever information. If it's still Q1, you can do that. I mean, this is just random text, you guys. You can make this whatever you want. And then you can click on these shapes right here, increase them to whatever they may be, and then make sure that this transition is morph. And that way it will slowly morph that rectangle from the first line to the second one as if it's growing as a bar chart. You don't have to go into any animation pane to make this nice and fancy. Usually if you did use animations for this instead of using the morph tool, it's gonna be a lot of work, but this is a super quick hack in order to grow these bar charts with ease. All right, so the last one I wanna show you guys is a little bit of a bonus animation that I wanted to include in this. Let's say we wanna go from Q2 to Q3. Well, here's another way you can do it. If I right click, it will slide from the right all the way off the screen to the left, and then in comes the new information. Now, this is a really cool feature I like to do is if you're like doing a timeline, you want to have the bar almost move off the screen and then more information comes onto the timeline. This is a great use case, but in this case, I just used more stats coming in. Now, how I actually did this animation? Well, it's not too complicated. So basically, you're gonna have your normal slide like usual right here. But then what you're gonna do is you're gonna copy and paste it, scoot it over here to the right like so, and that's what I did here. And then I just changed the text to be Q3 just cause. I mean, it can be whatever you guys are trying to use it for. And then what you're gonna wanna do is you're gonna wanna right click, duplicate this, highlight all this information, hold down shift, and just drag it like so. And now what's gonna happen is it's basically going to shift all your content from the right to the left, and then it's gonna look like it's smoothly coming into your slide. But just know that you can't delete this information right here, otherwise this animation is not gonna work properly. And same goes for this right here. You can't delete these objects right here, otherwise that morph animation will not work smoothly. So I hope you guys enjoyed my top three animations that I love to use in my PowerPoint presentations. If you guys did like this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up. And if you could subscribe, I would greatly appreciate the support. Also, if you are interested in learning all things related to PowerPoint, I do have a course on Udemy, so I'll link to that in the description below. But without further ado, I hope you guys have a great rest of your day, and I hope to see you guys in future videos. Thanks.